Hey YouTubers, the Big Kid here of BigKidReviews.com and many more, aka Archer's Friend on YouTube. I've been having a little problems with this bigger chainsaw for cutting the bigger logs we got. It's got a 20-inch bar. It's a Husqvarna 455 Rancher. You know, it's not the best saw in the world, but it's not too bad for, you know, a little farm ranchette or occasional, you know, cutting some wood, moving brush and stuff. It is rather heavy, and I don't like using it except for the big stuff because it's just too darn heavy and too dangerous. But anyway, it got to where it didn't want to oil the bar. And all that does is wear your bar out and your chain out, and it can wear your sprocket out. So needed to do something with it. Spraying oil on the bar ain't going to work. It just won't work, so forget that. However, it would end up leaking oil in the case when you store it. So I decided finally today, that's New Year's Day 2017, January 1. A beautiful day out here in northwest central Texas. You can see out there, it's in the 60s degree, not much wind, but we got a storm barreling down. It'll be here this afternoon, tonight, and then tomorrow, expecting possible severe weather. That's how it goes. Hot one day, air conditioner or fan blowing. Next day, you got the wood stove cooked up cherry red. So anyway, since we do have a wood stove, I need the saw working. So I don't know. I looked around on internet and first one thing and another and got some ideas and decided to take it apart. And one of the things that I have been doing to facilitate cleaning up, and I always like to clean the saw when we're through cutting wood, is to clean all the crap out of this clutch mechanism in here, brake, the emergency brake, kickback brake, whatever you want to call it, the bar adjuster and whatever. And to make it easier, I thought, hey, what I ought to do is to use my handy dandy air compressor blower gizmo and blow it out and blow that chain off, and it'd be a whole lot cleaner than, or faster than, washing that chain and you know, and solvent or something and taking it apart and oiling it. Well, that may have led to my problem. So I'm going to show you some things that I did to get the oiler working again. Now, this slot right up here, this is where the oil comes out to get on your bar. And I had no doubt in my mind with the blowing with the covers. I would usually take that cover off, and sometimes just to clean it up a little bit, I'd stick the blower in up here and blow and blow and blow all the chips out and the debris. And I think I blowed some wood shavings back in there and stopped up this tube. And the reason it would keep on leaking oil out on the case but not all in the bar is, I'll show you that in a minute. But now, to get to this spot here, it's a little tricky if you don't have the special tools and stuff. And so I had to call up on my redneck school of engineering degree to figure out how in the world we was going to get to these parts. And let me just sort of set it back together here and I'll show you what I'm talking about and how I figured it out. This is the clutch here, and then this is the drum that rides on the crankshaft. This fits in here, and it's left-hand threads, so it's screwed down on there. To get this off, as you can see, it's a special tool type thing going to be needed, some kind of a spanner wrench that fits in there. And you turn it this way with an impact, and you could have pretty good luck. But I don't have that special tool, And a lot of the people say you pull the plug and get it up on the compression stroke coming up, and then you stick a rope down in there, and then that locks the cylinder head to the piston and keeps it, holds it, so then you can get this off. Well, if you're lucky, your air impact with a special tool would take that without that rope trick. But I didn't have the special tool, and looking at them, to build one, you're going to sacrifice a socket and spend no telling how much time with some kind of grinder cutting the socket up so it fits down in there, and you'd have to have the right size and whatnot. And the only two places that it's going to be able to apply pressure is this little curve. Now, let me get a screwdriver and point to that rather than wiggling all over the place. Let's see if I can do this with one hand. But this right here, this little inset, and this one here. And of course it's backward thread or left hand thread, so you want to go to the right like you would normally tighten, and that's where it clamps, and it'll break this clutch assembly off of the shaft, drive shaft. Well, like I say, I didn't have the special tool. Before I dump this, I better put this down. So I got to looking, and my little spanner wrench, adjustable spanner wrench that I have here, I'm not sure where I picked that up, but those little things are not very strong, and so I suspected this was not going to work, and I didn't want to break that because there's other things I can use that spanner wrench for. So I went through my tools, and the socket grinding just didn't look like it would work. So I found out that this cheap 11/16 open end wrench would almost fit it. So what I did was just sacrifice one, and I came in here, see if I can set that up there, if it'll stay setting up there. Well, let's try something different. Let's try it like this. And down here on the inside, it needed to be a little bigger, so I ground that down so it would go in there. And then on this edge had to be thinned down some, and this edge had to be thinned down some, so that it would fit in here like this. Okay, and doing that, well, I needed to lock that piston some kind of way, so I went and resorted to the rope trick. And when I got this in there, I took a crescent wrench, and with it setting like this, and I just put the crescent wrench on here and braced it up against my body and put torque on there. And if you're real careful, you got to be careful with these rounded ones, the crescent will slip off. So, but a little practice in it, and it slipped, the wrench went flying and whatnot, and I thought, what am I going to do? Well, it turned out it had broken loose and twisted a little bit, so everything worked out real good. So that you spin it off like you were gonna do anything that's left-hand threads, that comes out, and then you got your drum here that applies to the torque. When the clutch spins fast enough, it'll go out and grab it, and then turn that chain. So you pull that off, and that's your drive sprocket. And I looked at it real close. This saw several years old, but like I say, it's so heavy, we only use it for real thick stuff. And the sprocket's in great shape, and you'll notice a couple of slots here. And what that does, well, first off, you lay that aside, and there's this little needle bearing sleeve here to keep that drum from wobbling. That comes off, and you set that aside. Now, what we've got here is this, it looks like a rubber grommet. Well, it's not. What that is that's the drive gear, and it's some kind of a plastic. The drive gear for your oil pump. And this here is kind of a protecting shield to protect that oil pump. It's got a screw there, so I've already taken that out. So you don't want to pry that up, because it's actually a worm gear. So let's go back and back it out, because the saw will turn clockwise when it's running. So you want to back this off by turning it counterclockwise, which is different from how you got that clutch assembly off. You just keep on going and going and going, and you wonder if it's doing anything or not, but you just keep on working with it, and you can see it's slowly coming up, and it'll finally release, and off it comes. Now, I've cleaned it. Now, this thing ought to be packed with grease. Now, see, it looks like a screw there, and that's actually a screw drive gear. And these little slots here, these little ears, well, that's what the slots in this sprocket, the notches in that, grab. And those little ears fit down inside there. The ears fit down in there, and then that's what drives this little guy. And once it gets down in there seated, all it does is spin. And you got to pull this plate off, this guard. And I've cleaned this up. I'm going to tell you, it was some kind of bunches of goobers after blowing air in it and stuff. And we now have our oil pump exposed. Let me get this where it's sitting, this one-handed thing. The tripod won't work too good because it's always in the way. But here's your oil pump right here. And then it gets oil out of your oil tank, and this is a little plastic thing that the oil pumps it into this tube, and it goes up here, and then it pukes it out onto your bar. Well, what was happening, and I had plugged that up, and this is not a very tight fit here, if it would sit like that. Let me just pause this, and I'll... Now, first off, I want to point out that I have gotten oil. You can see that oil shining up there. There was nothing coming out of there, but it's oil there now. But this whole thing, if you were just to hook your little screwdriver in there and lift that out, then it just comes off of here. It doesn't fit tight at all. And I'm not going to pull it out because I'll lose my oil that's in there. I'll push that right back. But the way this thing works, find this little gear here. And you slide, well, while this is off, this is your oil adjuster as far as the amount of oil. There's a screw down here on the bottom. And for a 20-inch bar, they say it should be maximum lubrication. And this little cam thing here drives this in and out, and it's on a taper, so that tells the pump how much oil it lets out, I suppose, some sort of way. But notice this little worm gear here. Okay, this turns. And when you take this apart, you need to look at this little plastic duty, because that's one of the things that gives out. You know, they break the teeth and then they won't grab and they won't go into here. But this one is in good enough shape. I'm going to slide that back on. And again, the rotation is to the right or clockwise. And it's screwing down onto that shaft. And let me turn it, excuse me a minute while I get this turned up so we can see here. And then we look under there, and as you turn this, Hopefully you can see that spline shaft rotating. As it rotates, it's getting the oil out of the oil tank, pumping it up into here, into this little cap that it just barely sits on there. There's it could easily leak if there's any obstruction whatsoever, and it pumps it on up to the chain. So after much to do and filling the thing with oil and pumping and pumping and pumping and going so slow, you know, it takes a while to get this, but it's now finally working, and at least by hand. So I think the whole problem was the blowing it out. I had forced chips down in here and plugged it. So other things that can happen is there's a filter inside that oil tank, supposedly, and it's a real booger beer to get to or replace, and I don't even want to think about having to do that. So the best thing to do is clean all around that oil filler cap before you start, and to put oil in there and make sure it's all clean, wipe it, blow it, do whatever you got to do to keep all the sawdust away from it, because if any gets down in there and plugs that thing up, and every time you make a cut, you ought to always hold that bar up against a piece of wood and rev her up, make sure it's throwing oil, and if it's not throwing oil, stop, because it's just going to ruin those chains. So that's what we did, or what I did, and got my little handy tool here. I don't know what a spanner socket or a wrench would cost for these things, but there isn't going to be finding one within 50-60 miles of here if you could even do that. So you'd have to order it and wait, and I just learned to make tools that'll work right on there what they're for. So that's what we did, and I'm pretty sure it's going to work. I'm going to finish watching the Dallas Cowboys play Philadelphia, and probably call it a day and go in and fix me some iced tea or something and watch the rest of the game. It's already, I can't see how much time's left up there. It doesn't matter. Anyway, just thought I'd show you that in case you ever get the situation. Now, this happens to be the Husqvarna, but all these saws have some sort of a system similar to this to make this the oiler work. Just make a note, you don't use an air thing to blow this apart unless you cover this up when you do it, and then you'll be all right. So I won't be doing that anymore until I cover this discharge slot from now on. Appreciate you hitting the subscribe button, like, share, plus whatever you like to do. Thumbs up, always appreciate it. And by the way, YouTube has always, in their uninfinite wisdom, making changes and making it harder for us that are affiliates with first one thing and another to advertise and monetize these things. And you know, if you don't see the get notified if you're a subscriber, then you're not gonna watch it unless you go to your subscriptions and go through there all the time, and that's a lot of trouble. Don't really expect people to do that, but there is a way that you can get notified. Now, it's a pain in the butt if you subscribe to somebody that makes a video every day or two videos a day. I even subscribe to one place, it'll put out as many as 6 or 7 videos a day, and I had to quit doing that because it just fills up your email box. But people like me and several others that are down to 1 a week or 2 a week at the very most, or 1 a month, those type things, to get notified when you hit the subscribe button, there's a little bell, icon of a bell, that shows up. Now, if you'll click on the bell, and then another box opens up, and then check that box, and tell it that's what you want, then you will get notified. But if you don't click the bell, it's however they feel like it. If you got a gun channel, or your stuff's about guns and shooting, you're likely never going to hear about it because of how the liberals work. But that's the new secret so far, until they find out some other way to screw us around. Click on the bell, you'll get notified when a new video comes out. And if you're making videos, you know, tell your subscribers, that's how to do it too. But if you're one of the people that makes several videos a day or a week, you're going to alienate people. They're not going to want to see that many, in my opinion. So anyway, that's a big kid signing out, and if there are any further developments, well, I may come back and make another clip, and it'll be a while before I get this all published and stuff. So belated New Year's to you. And it looks like Dallas probably just got through losing the ball game. Of course, they're playing third string people. But that's the way it goes. Yes, 27-13, Philadelphia won. And they need to save their people for the playoffs and eventually the Super Bowl. All righty. We'll catch you on the next video. And I'm going to go enjoy the rest of this few hours of good weather we got. See one of my girls over there wanting to have some extra feed before the storm hits. Big kid, see you on the next video. Have a good year. I'm looking forward to it. I'm sure glad Mr. Trump's in, and I've got great hopes. Catch you on the next one. Bye now.